Hey guys, welcome to SourceFed. I'm Joe Beretta. Around 12,000 years ago, a teenage girl around the age of 15 or 16 fell down a hole in the Yucatan Peninsula, broke her pelvis, and sadly faded from existence and into the dark recesses of history. As the last ice age receded, water from melting glaciers engulfed her remains, entombing her and the surrounding tunnels, creating a complex underwater cave system of preservation. In 2007, exploration divers discovered her remains, and today, her genetic footprint is shedding light on the origins of the first people of the Americas. Intriguing? Yes, stay tuned for now. Scientists graced her with the name Naia, naming her after Greek water spirits, as she was discovered in the dark, watery depths of a submerged cave system in the Yucatan jungle. The chamber she rested in is called Hoyo Negro, Spanish for black hole. It's a basketball arena-sized cave void of light, accessible only after a 30-foot jump into a sinkhole, followed by a leisurely 200-foot tunnel swim, capped off with a 100-foot dive into the abyss. Side note, the abyss is an outstanding movie. Watch the director's cut. Naia's pristine remains were surrounded by remnants of her ancient world. Saber-tooths and sloths and bears and pumas. It turns out this hole was a deadly all-species buffalo jump of doom. Her intact remains excited scientists, and they extracted DNA from a wisdom tooth in hopes of unlocking answers to the origin of the first American. A typically accepted theory here is that Native Americans were the first to grace the continent. They're related to early Siberians who crossed the Bering Strait somewhere around 17,000 years ago. But the problem scientists run into is that the earliest remains found on the continent don't resemble the features of modern Native American people. The older skulls found were narrower and longer, suggesting an African, Australian, or Southern Pacific Rim origin. The thing is, finding the smoking gun of remains is near impossible due to time and ancient cultural practices of burning the dead. Now, here's where Naia comes into play. She retains the features of the older Americans, with the longer and narrower face. But her DNA revealed that she is closely related to Native Americans on the genetic level, which is cool. What this effectively does is creates a genetic Bering Strait of sorts that connects the knowledge gap concerning America's first people. This evidence would support the theory that even though they looked different, the oldest Americans still crossed over with the early Native Americans on the land bridge, and their features just naturally evolved over time as they adjusted to the climate and became a, quote, more domesticated people. James Chatter's lead study author said, "The changes that make northernmost Native Americans look like most East Asian people are adaptations to cold environments. For instance, a flatter face and lower nose means that there are less parts of the body projecting out and potentially freezing off. Afterward, evolutionary changes that were advantageous during the expansion into the Americas were not necessarily so advantageous after people settled down, so other traits came to dominate." Thanks, James Chatters! Although this is all super cool, other smarties want to point out that this is just one example, and it doesn't necessarily ensure that this is 100% reality, but anyways, it's all super interesting stuff, and I highly suggest you guys read the articles linked in the description down below. And while you're there, why don't you anna-sub, like, ascribitate, and have yourself a spectacular day. My name's Joe Beretta, thanks for watching SourceFed.